Do you want to know how to build this circuit? Hey guys, in this video, I'll show you how to make a touch on and off switch using the 555 timer IC. Stay tuned to the second part of this video, where I'll explain how this circuit works. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. 7 jumper wires. I've removed the plastic covers from 4 jumper wires since they'll be used as touch probes. 1 220 ohms resistor. 1 LED. 1 555 timer IC. A battery holder with 4 AA batteries for the power source. A breadboard to connect everything together. The 555 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Pin 1, located at the top left, serves as the ground or ground supply. Pin 2, the trigger pin, initiates the timing interval in monostable and astable modes. Pin 3 serves as the output, providing the timer's operational result depending on its mode: monostable, astable, or bistable. Pin 4, the reset pin, is used to reset the 555 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 serves as the control pin, enabling you to adjust the threshold voltage levels used by the internal comparators to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6, the threshold pin, monitors the voltage of the capacitor in the circuit. Pin 7, the discharge pin, manages the timing capacitor's charge and discharge cycle. Pin 8, known as VCC, supplies power to the IC. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Begin by positioning the 555 timer IC on the breadboard. The pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left corner. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have questions about the circuit connections. Insert the 555 timer in the middle of the breadboard. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Insert one leg of the LED into pin 3 or output, and the other leg into a row above the 555 timer. Insert the longer leg into pin 3. Bend the ends of a 220 ohms resistor. Insert the 220 ohms resistor into the same row as the LED and the negative rail. Bend the ends of the touch probe. This is a jumper wire without the plastic cover. Insert the touch probe into pin 1 or ground and a few rows below the 555 timer. Straighten the touch probe. Bend the ends of another touch probe. Insert the touch probe into pin 2 or trigger and a few rows below the 555 timer. Make sure the touch probe in pin 2 isn't placed in the same row as the one in pin 1. This pair of touch probe is used to turn on the LED. Bend the ends of another touch probe. This is the touch probe for the right side. Insert the touch probe into pin 6 or threshold and a few rows below the 555 timer. Bend the ends of another touch probe. Insert the touch probe into pin 8 or VCC and a few rows below the 555 timer. This pair of touch probe is used to turn off the LED. It's time to connect the power supply. Attach the negative lead from the battery holder to the negative rail. Attach the positive lead from the battery holder to the positive rail. We have successfully completed the circuit. If you touch the right touch probes, the LED turns off. If you touch the left touch probes, the LED turns on. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. This setup creates a bistable circuit using the 555 timer IC, which means it has two stable states, on and off. By simply touching a pair of touch probes with your fingers, you trigger the circuit to turn the LED on or off. Your body conducts just enough electricity through the skin's natural conductivity to activate the input pins on the IC. When you touch these probes with your finger, your skin acts as a small resistor between pin 1 or ground and pin 2 or trigger. This causes pin 2 voltage to drop below 1/3 of the supply voltage. The 555 detects this low signal and sets pin 3 or output to high, turning the LED on. This is because in bistable mode, triggering pin 2 sets the output high. When you touch these probes with your finger, pin 6 is pulled high, going above 2/3 of VCC. The 555 detects this high threshold voltage and resets the output, turning it low. As a result, the LED turns off. In bistable mode, the 555 timer doesn't rely on timing cycles and doesn't need a capacitor to charge or discharge. It just reacts to simple voltage signals at two pins. Pin 2 or trigger to turn on. Pin 6 or threshold to turn off. I hope this video has shown you how to make touch on and off switch with a 555 timer. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.